Morning, students. In first chapter, continuation in logarithms. In today's class, I am going to explain exercise 1.5 problems. Here, in 1.5 fifth problem, remember this: fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. These four problems are important. I am going to explain our fifth problem. Here, what is given here? Yes, given this. Given. What is given here? Given x square plus y square equals to 25. Now, we have to prove that. We have to prove that 2 log of x plus y equals to 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y. Now, once again, here what he has given? Here he has given one condition. What is that? The condition is x squared plus y squared equals to 25. By using this condition, we have to prove that 2 log of x plus y equals to 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y. Now we have to show this. What do you have to show that? We have to show that x square plus y square equals to 25 given. Now I am going to explain all this. First I am taking x square plus y square equals to 25. Whatever he has given, that one first I am taking x square plus y square equals to 25. I am taking. Now we have to show that 2 log of x plus y equals to 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y. X square plus y square equals to 25 xy. X square plus y square equals to 25 xy. Now we have to prove that. Log of x plus y equals to 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y equals to 25 xy. Here he has given this condition. By using this condition, I have to show that this 2 log of x plus y. Now for this, what I am doing means, if you observe properly here, 2 log of x plus y means what? Something is there here. You are getting in the form of a plus b square. So due to that reason, to get a plus b whole square here, x square and y square, which term is not there here in this? 2xy term is not there. Once again, I am saying here, I am going to bring into the form of, here just you have a square plus b square only, plus 2ab not there. So due to that reason, here I am adding. What I am doing? Adding 2xy on both sides for x square plus y square equals to 25xy. For this, what I am doing? I am adding 2xy on both sides. If you add both sides, means what? X square plus y square plus 2xy equals to 25xy plus 2xy. Now, if you observe properly, this one, what you can write now? You can write it as a square plus b square plus 2ab. So indirectly, you can write it as a plus b, or else x square plus y square plus 2xy, you can write it as x plus y whole square equals to 25xy plus 2xy. You can write it as 27xy. X square, now what you got now? X square plus y square equals to 25xy, y has given. Now you are getting, what you got now? X plus y whole square equals to 27xy you got now. Now what you have to do means what? Taking log on both sides. Now if you observe properly, for this x square plus y square equals to 25xy. In this log, not there. But whenever he is asking to show that in this log is there. So that's why here I am taking log on both sides. Now for this, if you will take log on both sides, means what you will get? You will get now log of x plus y whole square equals to log 27xy. log of x plus y whole square equals to log 27xy. Now you apply the laws of logarithms for this. If you now you assume x plus y as single term, that is a, means if you apply the third law, if you apply the third law means what you will get? Now you will get 2 log of x plus y equals to, now observe RHS. For RHS also you have to apply the laws of logarithms. Log 27xy is there, means so 27 is 1, xy is different. So now you apply log xyz. If log xyz means what you can do, you can write it as log x plus log y plus log z. If you apply that law for that means you can write it as log 27 plus log x plus log y. You can write log 27 plus log x plus log y. Now if you observe properly, actually what you have to show, that you have to show that 2 log of x plus y equals to 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y. Now what you got? Now you got 2 log of, means what? You got LHS you got, but RHS you not got. In RHS also you got, out of 3 terms you got 2 terms. Which term you not got? This first term you not got. So now what you have to do, means what? 27 you express it as the product of the prime numbers. If you express it as the product of the prime numbers, means what? 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are. So 27, how you can write? Now you can write it as 2 log of x plus y equals to log 3 cube plus log x plus log y. Log 3 cube, still if you apply the laws of logarithm third law, by using third law, 2 log of x plus y equals to, you can write it as 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y. This is 2 log of x plus y equals to 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y. So you got that one. Actually here he has given that x square plus y square equals to 25xy. Here he has given this. By using this one, you have to show the 2 log of x plus y equals to 3 log 3 plus log x plus log y. Now just I am taking whatever he has given this, I am taking x square plus y square equals to 25xy. I have taken. For this, what I am doing, I am adding 2xy on both sides. If you add 2xy both sides, means what? X square plus y square plus 2xy equals to 25xy plus 2xy. This one you can write it as a plus b. 25xy and 2xy both are like terms, so you can add. These two are like terms, you can add. 25 plus 2, how much you will get? You will get 27xy. Now here I am taking log on both sides. Why I am taking log on both sides? Because here whatever he has given in this log not there. Whatever he is asking to show that in this log is there. So due to that reason here I am taking log on both sides. If you will take log on both sides, means what? What you will get? Always when you are taking log, means what? First you have to write the log, next you have to write the remaining terms. If I am, how I am writing? I am writing it as log of x plus y whole square equals to log 27xy. If you will apply that, then again log of x plus y whole square, if you will use log of a to the power of m, log a to the power of m, you can write it as m log a, you can write. If you will apply that, means what? 2 will come front. 2 log of x plus y equals to again log abc. Log abc you can write it as log a plus log b plus log c. Log 27 plus log x plus log y. So 2 log of x plus y equals to log 3 cube plus log x plus log y. Still this one, now we have, whatever you have to show that one complete. So finally here what you can do, you can write it, hence proved whatever he is asking that you got. No, this like this we proved this one problem. Next another one. Next, sixth problem. And what he has given that here? He has given that log of x plus y by 3 equals to 1 by 2 log of x plus y. Here he has given. Now, we have to find the value of x by y plus y by x value you have to find. Now if you observe the difference between fifth problem and sixth problem, in fifth problem what he has given, here he has given one condition, x square plus y square equals to 25xy, and he is asking to show that, whatever he is asking to show that in that logarithms are there. But in this problem, here whatever he has given in this logarithms are there, but whatever he is asking in that logarithms are not there. Means what? While doing the problem, somewhere these logs will go in this problem, and just will get the whatever is required. In previous problem, there he has given some condition. For that condition, we are taking the logarithms. That is exactly opposite to fifth problem. This is sixth problem is opposite to. In fifth problem, whatever he has given the condition as it is, we are taking. Somewhere in the middle, we are taking the logarithms and we are using the laws of logarithms. And again, we are using the laws of logarithms in that problem. But in this problem here, whatever he has given in this logarithms are there. So while doing the problem, in the middle somewhere, we'll remove this logarithms and whatever the required is asking, that one we'll find. Here, how we'll find means what? Whatever he is asking to log x, 1 by 2 log x plus log y. Okay. Whatever he has given, log of x plus y by 3 equals to 1 by 2 log x plus log y. Here he has given this condition. Now we have to find the value of x by y plus y by x value is how much you are getting. You have to find. If you observe properly, here you can use any law. No. So let it be this one, log of x plus y by 3. Once again, I am seeing here you can use any law of logarithm you have to apply. Here is there any law of logarithm not there? So let it be that one, like that only. So again afterwards we will use that one later afterwards. Now which equals to 1 by 2. Now again if you observe log x plus log y. Log x plus log y means what? What you can write now? We can write it as log xy. You can write already, you know, log x plus log y. Second law. First law. Log x plus log y. Log x plus log y. Opposite. Log x y. How you can write it as log x plus log y. So in the same way, log x plus log y exactly opposite to this log x y. First law that is. So now, still you can use any law of logarithm? No. Let it be log x plus y by 3 equals to. Now, here 1 by 2 is before the log and log x y is there. For this again, you can use any law. Third law. If you use the third law, log m log a to base x, we can write it as log a to the power of m to the base x. What is the law you have? M log a to the base x. How you can write? We can write it as log a to the power of m to the base x. We can write. How we can write? M log a to base x. We can write it as log a to the power of m to the base x. By using that third law, 1 by 2, how we can write? We can write it as log xy whole to the power of 1 by 2. Log xy whole to the power of 1 by 2. Now, if you observe properly here, log x plus y by 3 is again here also log x. Is there any number before the log? Not there. Here also there is no number. So, whenever it is like that, when you can do like this, means what? In between them equals to. Whenever equals to is there, LHS only single logarithm and RHS also when you have only single logarithm. Once again, I am saying for an equation, if LHS only one logarithm and RHS also you have only one logarithm, in that case, then you can remove this cap. Then you can remove this logarithm. That only you can cancel this logarithm. If you remove the logarithms, means what? X plus y by 3 equals to what you can write now? You can write it as xy whole to the power of 1 by 2. Nothing but square root to the power of 1 by 2. To the power of 1 by 2. Now, to remove this power 1 by 2, what I am doing? I am doing squaring on both sides. Here, why I am doing this squaring on both sides? To remove this 1 by 2. To remove this squaring on both sides. If you do squaring on both sides, means what will happen? X plus y whole square by 3 square equals to xy to the power of 1 by 2. Again, for this, what I am doing? Square you are doing. If we do square means what will happen now? X plus y. Whole square means what? X square plus y square plus 2xy by 9 equals to, means what will happen now? Xy whole to the power of 2 by 2. A to the power of m, whole to the power of m. A to the power of m, n means what? Means 2 ones are, you can cancel. So now what it will remain now? X square plus y square plus 2xy equals to 9xy. Here nothing, all will goes cancel, or else I will write one more step. By 9 by 9 equals to xy. If you do cross multiplication, means what? X square plus y square plus 2xy equals to 9xy. 2xy if you transpose to RHS means what? X square plus y square equals to 9xy minus 2xy. Next, x square plus y square equals 9xy and 2xy both are like terms. Like terms, you can do subtraction. So 9x minus 2xy, how much you will get? We will get it as 7xy. Now we observe. What you have to find? You have to find the value of x by y plus y by x prime. But here, whatever you got in the square terms are. So to remove this square, still what I will do means what? X square plus y square by xy equals to 7. You have to find value. Value means what? It is a numerical number. Whatever the variables are there, I am bringing it to LHS. So here in between them, what is the multiplication? It will become transpose. If you transpose means what next? Again separate the terms, x square by x by, again y square by xy equals to 7. Means numerator 1x, denominator 1x, numerator 1y, denominator 1y goes cancel. Then what it will remain now? X by y plus y by x equals to 7. So indirectly, what is the value of x by y plus y by x value is 7. Once again, I am explaining now. Here, whatever he has given this, log of x plus y by 3 equals to 1 by 2 log x plus log y, here he has given this. Now he is asking to find the value of x by y plus y by x value is how much. If you observe properly, whatever he has given in this, logarithms are there. So we have to use the some loss of logarithms by using log x plus log y, first law. What you can write it as log x y. Next, log x plus y by 3 equals to 1 by 2 log x y m. Again, you use the third law. If you use the third law, log xy whole to the power of 1 by 2. So here, already I said you, for an equation, LHS only single logarithm and RHS also only single logarithm are there. In that case, you can remove the logarithms. If you remove the logarithms, means what? X plus y by 3 equals to 1 by 2, x to the power of 1 by 2. Here, indirectly, power 1 by 2 is nothing but also this one you can write like this also. Indirectly also you can write it as square root. To the power of 1 by 2 is nothing but square root, or else you can write it as 1 by 2 also you can write. You do squaring on both sides. If you do squaring on both sides means what? You simplify that. Whatever you are getting, what you are getting the value of x by y plus y by x value is 7. Now in the same way, another one. Next, seventh one. What is that next seventh problem? Seventh problem, what is given here? He has given that. What is given? 2.3 whole to the power of x equals to 0.23 whole to the power of y equals to 2.3 whole to the power of x equals to 0.23 whole to the power of y equals to 1000. Then you have to find the value of 1 by x minus 1 by y value you have to find. Before going to this problem, already you know, you learnt in lower classes that if A equals to B equals to C, then before going to this problem once again, if A equals to B equals to C, then from this what you can write? We can write it as A equals to B, you can write it as B equals to C, and also you can write it as A equals to C. These three you can write. You can write it as A equals to B, B equals to C, and also you can write it as A equals to C. Already everyone you know this. Now whatever this problem is there, we are going to do problem by using this one. If A equals to B equals to C there, you can write it as A equals to B, B equals to C, and also you can write it as A equals to C. Now in the same way, whatever he has given this, if you observe properly, in this formula, A equals to B equals to C only. Just only if A equals to B equals to C means what, you can write it as A equals to B, B equals to C, and also A equals to C. In the same way, A equals to B equals to C. So from this, what I can write now? I can write it as 2.3 whole to the power of x, A equals to B equals to C. So I can first I will write A equals to C, 0.23 whole to the power of x equals to 1000 is 1. And what is that? Another one is 0.23 whole to the power of y equals to 1000. 0.23 whole to the power of x equals to 0.23 whole to the power of y equals to 1000. 0.23 whole to the power of x equals to 1000. This I am right here. Out of those three conditions, this here I am using A equals to C and B equals to C. These two conditions I am using. Now 0.23 whole to the power of y equals to 1000 is 1 and 2.3 whole to the power of x is 1. Now if you observe properly, LHS base is 2.3 and the power is x. So first of all, just what I will do means what, LHS 2.3, this one equation total you divide by x means what, 2.3 whole to the power of x by x equals to, okay, first I will write like this. First I am writing it as, still I can write, how you can write, you can write it as 2.3 to the power of x equals to 10 cube, 2.3 to the power of x equals to 10 cube, and another one is 0.23 whole to the power of y equals to, also you can write it as 10. Now here to make it as a LHS single base, and this equation total I am dividing it by x means what, 2.3 whole to the power of x, its power I am dividing, 2.3 whole to the power of x by x equals to 10 to the power of 3 by x. Here what I am doing, this whatever he has given, that one I am taking, 2.3 whole to the power of x equals to 1000. This 1000 you can write it as 10 cube, already you know. Its power I am dividing by x. LHS power I am dividing by, whenever you are dividing its power, LHS by x means what, in the same way you have to divide by RHS also, you know that. If an equation, if you do any operation LHS, the same operation you have to do RHS also. Now here numerator x1's you can cancel. Now what is left now? 2.3 equals to 10 to the power of 3 by x. 2.3 equals to 10 to the power of 2.3 equals to 10 to the power of 3 by x. You got one thing. Now in the same way you do for this equation also, how much you will get now? 0.23 means what? Now its power you divided by y. So how much you will get now? 0.23 whole to the power of y by y equals to 10 to the power of 3 by y. Here I am, its power I am dividing by x. Now what I am doing? Its power I am dividing by y. Means what? Y to the power of 1 by y to the power of 1. So how much now I will get now? 0.23 equals to 10 to the power of 3 by y. Now finally what you got? You got the value of 2.3 value is 10 to the power of 3 by x, and 0.23 value is 10 to the power of 3 by y. Let it be these two values like this. Now what you have to find, you have to find the value of 1 by x minus 1 by y value is how much. Now I got the value of 2.3 value is 10 to the power of 3 by x, and 0.23 value is 10 to the power of 3 by y. Now already you know this 0.23, this 0.23 I can write it as 2.3 by 10. If you observe properly, in the denominator, if I will remove one zero, means what indirectly what it will get now 2.3, what it will become 0.23. Once again, 0.23 you can write it as 2.3 by 10. Indirectly nothing, but in the denominator, if you will remove one zero, means what 2.3 what it will become 0.23. Already you know. This is important. Here just I am writing, here I am not using any condition like that, just 0.23, I am writing it as 2.3 by 10, just if you in the denominator, if you remove one zero means what, how much you will get, a 0.23. Now 0.23 value, already you know 0.23 value, how much will you will get, 10 to the power of 3 by y equals to 2.3 value, 2.3 value is 10 to the power of 3 by x by 10. 10 is nothing but all, you can write it as 10 to the power of 1. 10 you can write it as 10 to the power of 1. 10 you can write it as 10 to the power of 1. Now 10 to the power of 3 by y equals to here a to the power of m by a to the power of n. If you use the loss of logarithms, how much you will get now? 10 to the power of 3 by x minus 1. 10 to the power of 3 by x minus. Now here the bases are same. In between them equals to it, so powers are also equal. So now how you can write, as now 3 by y equals to 3 by x minus 1. Now what is asking here is asking to find the value of 1 by x minus 1 by y value is asking to find 1 by x minus 1 by y. Now if you observe properly, you got, okay, already you got almost some relation. What you got? Denominator in the variables, you got in the denominator part. Now what you got, just 1 by x first, which term should be there first, 1 by x term minus 1 by y. So to that I am transposing 3 by y to RHS and 1 to LHS, then indirectly what it will become, 1 equals to 3 by x minus 3 by x minus 3 by y. Now still 1 by x, this 3 by x should become 1 by x, fine. In the numerator you can take 3 as common. If you will take 3 as common means what? 1 by x minus 1 by, here in the numerator just I am taking 3 as common. If you will take 3 as common means what? 1 equals to 3 into 1 by x minus 1. Again if you will do cross multiplication, means what? 3 you do cross multiplication, it will become 1 by 3. 1 by 3 equals to 1 by x minus 1 by, therefore what you can write now, you can write it as 1 by x minus 1 by y equals to 1 by 3. Now you got the value of 1 by x minus 1 by y value is 1 by 3 you got. Now next another problem, in this problem, this is just that up to here already easy, just 0.23 I am writing it as 2.3 by 10. After to substitute the values, ordinary simplification only this is. Next 7th problem, yeah, okay, 8th and what is that? Here what is given, given 2 to the power of x plus 1 equals to 3 to the power of 1 minus x. 2 to the power of x plus 1 equals to 3 to the power of 1 minus x. Now again what is asking, he is asking to find the value of x. Now if you observe properly in this problem, here the bases are same, bases are not equal, and again you observe powers are same, powers are also not same. You remember in loss of exponents, there you, if the bases are same then the powers are equal. There you remember, already you know the loss of logarithms, if a to the power of m equals to a to the power of m, then m equals to n, in loss of exponents you will learn. Now if you observe properly, here the bases are not same and also powers are also not same. Whenever you will get like this an equation, the bases are not same or the powers are also not same, in those cases you will apply the laws of logarithms, you will use the logarithms concept and you will find the So find its values or find its solution will do. Now here bases are not same, powers are also not same. So that's why I am taking log on both sides. Here the bases are not same and powers are also not same. So that's why I am taking log on both sides. Here what I will write, I am writing taking log on both sides, or else apply taking log on I am taking logarithm on both sides. If you will take log on both sides, means what? Log of 2 to the power of x plus 1 equals to log 3 to the power of 1 minus x. Understand now? First one I said here, why I am taking logarithms? Why I am taking logarithms? Because here the bases are not same, power are also not same. For an equation, whenever you will get like this, if the bases are not same, powers are not same, means what? Indirectly you take the log on both sides. This I am taking log on both sides. Now afterwards what you have to do, means what? You have to apply the laws of log. Now you observe log a to the power of m, means what? M x plus 1 you assume it as m1, x plus 1 this total you assume it as only single value, assume log a to the power of m. If log a to the power of m, can write it as m log a, use it third law, loss of logarithm third law. If we use the third law, means what? X plus 1, this x plus 1 is single term, x plus 1 log 2 equals to, again use loss of logarithm third law, means 1 minus x log 3. Now you write since log a to the power of m equals to m log a, log a to the power of m equals to m log a. Now I am using x plus 1 log 2. Now already how you will do it? Simplification, ordinal simplification. Here x plus 1 into log 2 is there. Means what? This total you have to multiply by log 2. So x into log 2, how much now it will become? It will become x log 2. Here what is there? Plus 1 into log 2, means what? It will become log 2. 1 into log 2, 1 into any number, same. Which equals to 1 into log 3, will get log 3 minus x into log 3, how much I will get? I will get x log 3, x log 3 minus. Now in the question, first only what is asking, is asking to find the value of log 3 value is asking. Now what is asking, is asking to find the value of x value is asking, means you have to find the value. Now x, whenever he is asking x value, means what? X should be LHS and the number should be RHS. So transpose x to LHS, then what it will become now? X log 2, transpose x to LHS, x log 2 plus x log 3 equals to log 3, transpose log 2 L RHS, means what? Minus log 2, x log 2 plus x log 3 equals. Now he is asking to find x, so in this here both are x, so you can take x as common. If I will take x as common, means what? X log 2 plus log 3 equals to log 3 equals to log 3 minus log 2, x log 2 plus log 3. Already you know this, log a plus log b, you can write it as log a b. So log 2 into 3 equals to log a minus log b, you can write it as log a by b, means what? Log 3 by 2. So which equals now x equals to, or else x log 6 equals to log 3 by 2. So what you can write, you can write it as x equals to log 3 by 2 divided by log 6. Why? Because it's asking to find the x value. So transpose log 6 to, so what is the value of x value? X equals to log 3 by 2 by log 6 is the value. Or else up to here only you can do, or else you do cross multiplication. So what you got the value? You got the value of x equals to log 3 by 2 by log 6. Here in textbook he gave different answer, up to here only has given and stuff. So still I am doing simplification. M log a minus log b, log a by b, that is log 3 by 2, log a plus log b, log a. No, two problems I am giving homework, similar problems. Remember that solve, whenever you will ask solve means what, in that whatever the variable is it, indirectly you have to find that where. Solve is nothing but solve seven to the power of x equals to seven to the power of x equals to nine to the power of x minus four. Solve 7 to the power of x equals to 9 to the power of x minus 4. You solve this problem. And again another one. If this problem, in homework, first problem is similar to 8th problem. Exercise 1.5, 8th problem. Now second problem. Homework, if x square plus y square equals to 6xy, then prove that, whatever you have to prove that, you have to prove that 2 log of x plus y equals to log x plus log y plus 3 log 2. This problem, this second problem is similar to in exercise 5th problem. Second problem is similar to in exercise 5th problem. Two similar problems I give homework for you. Now next I am going to tell you another, that is 9th problem. What is asking now in exercise 9th problem now? Is log 2, 9th bit first one. Is log 2 is rational or irrational is asking. Is log 2 is rational or irrational is asking. And justify your answer. Log 2 means I don't know its value. So what I am assuming, already I said you in logarithms, whenever you will not give any base means what, you have to take, you have to consider its base as 10. I don't know its value. So what I am assuming, let, I don't know the value of log 2 to the base 10. So that's why I am assuming let x equals to log 2 to the base 10. Now this in the form of which form it clearly? Your log is there, so that's why indirectly this is in the form of logarithmic form. You convert into exponential form. If you will convert into exponential form, what you will get? You will get 10 to the power of x equals to 2. Clear? Once again, I am seeing is asking that log 2 is rational or irrational. So due to that reason, I don't know the value of log 2 to the base 10. That's why I am assuming it as x. If you will assume it as x means what, x equals to log 2 to the base 10. This is in the form of logarithmic form. You convert into exponential form. 10 to the power of x equals to 2. Now afterwards you have to observe. Anywhere 2 to the power of, suppose if I will take x equals to 1. If I will take x equals to 1 means what you will get? 10 equals to 2. Anywhere 10 equals to 2, is it possible? It does not possible. If I will take x equals to 1, then what you will get? 10 to the power of 1 is not equals to 2. Then 10 to the power of 1 is not equals to 2. So what you will say, we will say that whenever you will not get like this wrong, you will get. So what you will say that? So we will say that log 2 to base 10 is irrational. What you can say? We can say that it is irrational number. It is irrational number. Log 2. If suppose you will get, suppose here any 100 is there. Directly you can say 10 square equals to 100, then it is possible. So in that case what you can say, that log 100 to the base 10 or it is a rational number. Next, another problem he has given, that in this 9th bit second one, what is asking is log 100 rational or irrational is asked. Is log 100 is rational or irrational? Now already I said whenever you will not give any base, you have to assume how much you have to take, you have to consider its base as 10. I don't know its value, so that's why what I am assuming, let x equals to log 100 to the base 10. Indirectly, this is in the form of exponential form. You convert into logarithmic form. If you convert into logarithmic form, means what? 10 to the power of x equals to 100. 10 to the power of x equals to 100. Now, 10 to the power of x equals, this 100 I can write it as 10 square. Now, if you observe problem, here the bases are same. In between them, equals to is there. So, indirectly, what you will get? You will get x equals to 200. Observe the difference between problem here. Here I got 10 to the power of x. If I will take x equals to 1, 10 to the power, anyway 10 is not equals to. But here what is happening? I got indirectly x value. What is that x? Already x value is 2. Already you know 2 is a rational number. 2 is a rational number. So what you can say, therefore, log 100 to the base 10 is also a rational number. If you will get this is rational, means what? Whatever this number, this one also. If this is irrational, means what? This one also irrational you will get. Now this problem you can do in another method also. This is one method and another. Log 100 to the base 10 is asking directly. Log 100 to the base 10. 100 how you can write? You can write it as 10 square. You can 10 square to the, you apply the loss of logarithm. If you apply the loss of logarithm, means what? You apply the third law. If you apply the third law to log 10 to the base 10, already know whenever in logarithms, whenever the number and the base have the same number, means what? In there its value is 1. So 2 into log 10 to the base 10 value, since log 10 to the base 10 value is 1. So 2 into 1, how much you will get? No, you will get 2. 2 is a rational number. So log 100 to the base 10 is also rational. By this exercise is completed. Now I am going to tell you another problem that is important. Find the number of digits in another problem. This is in optional exercise one problem that is important, even though I am saying optional exercise problem. I am telling you in optional exercise fifth problem. Find the number of digits in is asking. Find the number of digits in. Find the number of digits in 4 to the power of 2013 if log 2 to base 10 value is 0.3010 is asked. Yeah, he has given this one problem. See, actually if you want to do by regular process, it is a 2 square value. How many digits you will get? 1 digit will. 2 square means what? 2 you will multiply 2 times. In the same way, 4 to the power of 2013 means what? 4 how many times you have to multiply? 2013 times you have to multiply. Again, after finding that calculation, in that how many digits is there? Is it possible by ordinary method? It does not possible. So in those cases, by using this logarithm, now you understood what is the use of this logarithm, means what? Whenever you want by actual method, in those cases we will use the logarithms and we'll find its values. For actually for writing 4 2013 times only, it is a big calculation. Again, in that to find how many digits is it not, it is not possible by ordinary method. So by using this logarithms, we'll find in 4 to the power of 2013 how many digits are there. Now so now I am doing its solution. Now so whatever he has given, this first time taking, what is given here? Given log 2 to the base 10 value is 0.3010. Instead of this, I am simply directing 0.301 I am taking. Now whatever you are, let x, I don't know how many, let x equals to 4 to the power of 2013. What is asking? 4 to the power of 2013, how many digits are there? I don't know. So that's why I am assuming let x equals to 4 to the power of 2039. So here it is not possible by direct method. So that's why I'm taking log on both sides. Taking log on both sides. You take logarithms on both sides. If you will take logarithms on both sides, means what? Log x equals to log 4 to the power of 2030. Log 4 to the power of 2000. Already all you know that 4 still, how you can write now? Again, log x equals to log 4 still, you can write it as 2 square, you can write. Means what? 2 square 2 to the power of 2013. Again, log x equals to log. Why I am writing 2 square? Because here he has given log 2 to the base 10 only. So this 4 you can write it as 2 square. Due to that reason I am writing it as 2 square means what? Log 2 to the power of 2 into 2013. A to the power of m whole to the power of m. A to the power of m into m. Again log x equals to log 2 to the power of means what? 4, 0, 2, 6, 2, 3, 2. How much you will get? Log x equals to log 2 to the power of 4026. Again, log x equals to log x equals to use the loss of logarithm third log a to the power of m. Log a to the power of m you can write it as m log a. So log x equals to 4026 into log 2. If base is not given, how much you have to take? You have to consider it as base 10. Already I am taking now, which equals to 4026. It already has given log 2 to the base 10 value is how much now? 0.301. Means you multiply 4026 by 301. By 301 multiply means what? How much? 4026 2 3 4 0s. Next, how much you get? 3 6 18. 3 2 6 7 0 4 3 12 6 2 8 8 7 plus 3 10 11 11 7 plus 11 1. How much will you get? You will get its value is, if you multiply 4026 into 0.30, and if you multiply means 1 2 11 1 8 26. Here decimal point is after 3 digits. Again you keep decimal point after 2 digits. Means how much you will get now? 1211.86. Here decimal point is after 8. So how much you will get indirectly, which equals to nearest values 1212. This is approximately APP. So in 4213, how many digits are there? Total 1212 digits are there. Okay, enough for today's class.